I've been a little busy, so this video has been delayed a little bit. Today I'm going to show you how to install Hal9k 5 mod on a device that isn't on Android 10 with only free tools. So let's begin. Links will be in the description, and what you'll need for this is a USB to USB cable, so you can plug your computer into your USB ports on your head unit. You'll need a flash drive or micro SD card, and you'll need the files that I have linked. This method will delete everything, so be aware of that. If you want to upgrade without deleting everything, then use Hal9k Mod InstallerPro, but this is how to do it without it. First, let's unzip all these packages. If you don't have the drivers installed, use Driver Assist to install them. I already have them installed, so I'm going to skip this part. Let's open the RKDevTool folder and select the config.ini. File and change language selected to 2. So it will be in English. Now let's open RKDevTool. Let's plug the USB into our computer and our device. On mine, it's the yellow USB. It varies depending on the head unit. This will be trial and error. So follow the next couple of steps and put it in MaskRom first before you try which USB is which, if you don't already know. Now this is probably the most difficult part. We're going to push and reset on our device. Hold it in until the lights flash. Then we're going to let it go and we're going to push it again. And hopefully you'll see a device on RKDevTool. This is MaskRom mode, and it'll probably take a couple tries to get this just right. The screen should say black after you push it the second time. If it reboots again, then you have to try it again. And only one USB port will work, so switch them out to see which one's which when it's at the black screen like it should be, because it will be in MaskRom mode. With the loader device found, we're going to click on firmware. And we're going to select a firmware that we have downloaded for our device. That is Android 10 and image format. I'll send you a link to where you can find ROMs, and it has to be an image format for this. It cannot be a zip file. Now we're going to select this image. And when you see it loaded under firmware, we're going to click upgrade. Now this might fail once or twice. Just keep trying it again. This will install the firmware in recovery. That's why we need to do this. This is why it's necessary. You'll need a full ROM and not an OTA for this.
When it finishes, we'll see the head unit reboot, the boot animation, and then the Android 10 ROM we just installed. We can go ahead and close RKDevTool now. And we're going to plug in a USB or micro SD card to our computer, depending on which one you want to use. USB is usually faster. And we're going to go to the Hal9k folder and copy over the update.zip directly to the root folder of the flash drive or micro SD. Now when it finishes, let's eject it and plug it into our head unit. Now when we plug it in, it should have a pop-up after a couple seconds. And we're going to select Wipe Data and Format Flash. And then we're going to click Install. You'll get something like this where it says Installing System Update. Just wait for this to get finished. Wait a few moments on initial boot to let it install Magist and soft reboot. But after that, you now have Hal9k Mod version 5. Magist is now updatable in this Hal9k mod. It hasn't been previously. In another video, I will show you how to do that, but it's pretty straightforward.